الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the time passed very quick. We just say to Ramadan salam, and now we say to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, اللهم بارك لنا في شعبان وبلغنا رمضان. We ask him سبحانه وتعالى for all of us to witness the month of Ramadan, the month of Rahmah and Maghfirah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of his ahadith, he said, يَتَقَارَبُ الزَّمَانِ the zaman, the time will get very fast, very close, and we see it these days. But when we are reach the month of Sha'ban, and a few days passes already, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's telling us this month arrived between Rajab and Ramadan. One of the forbidden months, Rajab, and people alert and celebrate and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the month of Ramadan, which the month of maghfirah and rahmah, mercy and love from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his ibad. You're fasting, you donate, you give sadaqat, you give zakah, but the people not aware by the importance of the month of Sha'ban. Said Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha, she said this when she asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the fasting. He said he fasts the most days on Sha'ban, most days, not the whole month. And she stated that. But Sayyidina Usama, he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, ma li araka tasumu akthar ayyam Sha'ban? Why I see you fasting most of the days on Sha'ban? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadha shahrun yaghfal anhu an-nas. This is a month, people are not aware of it. Fihi turfa'u al-a'malu ila Allah. In this month, all the deeds for the last year until the middle of Sha'ban, and some of the scholars said at the end of Sha'ban, Allah alam rasuluh, all your deeds for the whole years will be raised, elevated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you start a new year after that counting. وَأُحِبُّ أَن تُرْفَ أَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ. And I hope that all my deeds reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while I'm fasting. And who is the speaker? Is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now we are in the earth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in his house. We need to ask ourselves, how is the last year deeds for us, the good and the bad? Sometimes we do a lot of deeds, good deeds, and Allah never counted. And some less, and he counted. And same thing as the bad deeds. So we need to correct ourselves before all our deeds elevated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To do this correction, we have to remind ourselves but what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling us in the Isra and Mi'raj, and he saw it in the dream, or he got from Jibreel alayhi salam. Three small things We're going to share it and then we see how we can correct ourselves. We're not scared ourselves, it's alert. Because Sayyidina Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he said, the day and night working for you, son of Adam. So be alert and work. Yes, we see today the life is 24/7, mashallah, and people open business for 24/7 because the day and night Allah created for you, son of Adam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he alert us for what he saw in Isra and Miraj and every other occasions, he saw people coming from the river, out of the river, and fully blood in their mouth. And the malaika, they throw the stone in their mouth, and they go back again to the river, burn it, and come back again fully blooded. And when he asked Jibreel alayhi salam, who they are, Ya Akhi Ya Jibreel, he said, those are people who's eating the wealth of the orphaned. And so many stories today about that. And then he saw some people get swallow stomach and they roll it on it. And he said, who they are? He said, those the people who eat the riba, the haram. They eating riba, haram. They don't care. Those the people who earn with no questioning if they think it's haram, so يَأْكُلُونَ فِي بُطُونِهِمْ نَارًا, so they eat in their stomach a fire, وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Then he saw another people, they have dishes. One has a good food and the one is a rotten food. And he said, أخي يا جبريل, what is it? This is the people who do the adultery. They get the halal, but they're still looking for the haram with another people. وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. This is only small things for the hellfire, وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. But we are believers, and alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, أُمَّة Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ, people of the Jannah. Fear would be Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he go under the Arsh al-Rahman, he say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أُمَّتِي أُمَّتِي, he say, Ya Muhammad, raise your head. لَن نُخْزِلُكَ فِي أُمَّتِكَ أَبَدًا, we'll never put you down in your ummah. He say, Ya Allah, my ummah, say, Ya Muhammad, raise your head, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we'll never put you down. It's your ummah. أَتَرْضَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ, do you like that? Say, Ya Allah, لَا وَلَنْ أَرْضَ وَوَاحِدْ مِنْ أُمَّتِي فِي النَّارِ, I cannot, Ya Allah, take that one of my people in the hellfire, وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. But that some people will come in the hawd and they try to get closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the malaika will reject it then, say, Ya Muhammad is not from you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, we need to do correction. We need to talk to ourselves. Between two surah and the Holy Quran, it will take us directly for Surah Al-Fajr. When the end of Surah Al-Fajr, كَلَّا إِذَا دُكَّتِ الْأَرْضُ دَكَّا دَكَّا وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلُكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ أَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. So when the end come, he say, oh Allah, I wish I can do something better. And some ayat, he's going to ask Allah to go back, not to do the prayer. فَأَتَ صَدَّقَ, to give sadaqah. Imagine the importance of the sadaqah. Sadaqah can help and save you from the hellfire, وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Now in Surah Al-Zumur and Surah Al-Haqqah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he starts by the disbeliever in Surah Al-Zumur. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمُرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ وَيُنْذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. All disbelievers, there's anyone come to you, alert you by this time, by this moment? قالوا بلى. Yes, it came. But حقت كلمة العذاب على الكافرين. It's over. Cannot do anything. قيل ادخلوا أبواب جهنم خالدين فيها. فبئس مثوى المتكبرين. Go off to hellfire والعياذ بالله. But when you go to Surah Al-Haqqa, Allah started a different way. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينَ. Now he talk about the good people first. And after that, in Surah Al-Zumar, he talk about the good people. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. And Surah Al-Haqqa. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِ فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوْتَ كِتَابِيَا وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَا. يا ليتها كانت القاضية. ما أغنى عني مالية. هلك عني سلطانية. Now, see how is the beauty of the Quran? It's alert. Now, we need to ask ourselves which body we need to be. Among the believers, they put their hand together with the family to جنات الله سبحانه وتعالى. وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرة. Together in جنات الله. Oh, you need the other والعياذ بالله. Because it's going to be حساب and عقاب. الحق is the ساعة, is the timing, is the day of judgment. And you need to be among the people say, I wish I don't get the book. No, we need to get the book by our right hand. That's how our goal is. How we do that? How we get this point? Before our deeds reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala تعرض عليه الأعمال, all the deeds elevated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Fajr and the Asr time daily. And Monday and Thursday weekly. And the middle of Sha'ban or the end, as the ulama said, Allahu a'lam wa rasul. For the whole year. Now, what we did last year, can we count it? What we did right, what we did wrong? Starting from our home. Because we're gonna be asking for that. Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha, she asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very simple question. She said, Ya Rasulullah, ما هو حق المرأة على أهلها? What is the righteous for the woman in her family? Who is the most important person she being responsible for? And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, her husband. I said, Ya Rasulullah, what about the man? He said, his mother. وَتُسْأَلُ الْمَرْأَةَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And the woman should be asked in the day of judgment about two things front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. صَلَاتِهَا وَزَوْجِهَا. Her prayer and her husband. Because of that, among the creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, subhanahu wa ta'ala, his creation, is the marriage. So the marriage is very important. We need to correct our life together inside our house. You have responsibility and she has responsibility. This is the way we have to understand. We meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're gonna be asking about everything. You are the man, you are responsible of the house. Not let it go, it's fine. We are going through a lot of hard time with our teenagers. Every masjid, I'm not gonna skip anyone. All the masajid, they have a problem. Family cannot control the teenagers. But we have rules to help and support, advice. How? The house of Allah. Bring them to the house of Allah. Talk to them. Ask them about the salah, the importance of the salah. Marriage is important, yes. What about the parents? Ask yourself, if things happen to your parents, what you will do? And who's important in your life? And put in front of your eyes, Al-Jannah, for the people who obey their parents. So it's not your wife, it's your mother and your father. They burned their life to
to let you grow up as a man. When they get old, you see their mouths cannot even talk well. These very low voices, they don't speak high. They are come down waiting for you to help them. Waiting for you to put the smile in their face. Waiting for you to give them the medication by your hand. Waiting for you to give them shower if they cannot. Wallahi, it's burning our hearts when we hear a sister, she go and give a shower for her father-in-law. Because his son and his daughter don't want to do it. Where we at from our parents? وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. We said it every time. Your parents first. Your house, spouse together, warm the relation. This is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's his book and the sunnah of Muhammad. How he was dealing with his wives and with his children and with the grandkids. That's how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the man was sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn, they run to Rasulullah, he hugged them and gave them a kiss. And the man looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, are you hugging them and giving them a kiss? How are you going to be strong in a man? He said, do you have kids? He said, I have 10. He said, go and change your heart. Love. That's a word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So before the month of Ramadan starts and we'll be prepared for it, we have to correct ourselves today. هَذَا شَهْرٌ يَغْفَلْ عَنْهُ النَّاسِ. This is the most important month for all of us. Very important. Let your deeds reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in very good shape. What we have to do? Dua, salah. Promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tubtu ila Allah, raja'tu ila Allah. Allah imprinted for you. I'm not going to do any mistakes anymore. Oh Allah, I made a mistake, but I don't know it's a mistake and count. Remove it for me. Oh Allah, taqabbal my sadaqat. Look at the sahaba, radwanullah alayhim, in the month of Sha'ban, they gave a sadaqat and a zakah, and they said the month of Ramadan when arrived, we want to be free for the ibadah only. Only for the ibadah. Nothing can disturb us. So they do everything before the month of Ramadan, mainly in Sha'ban, so they are be free in the month of Ramadan. How many of us today start open the Mus'haf and read and understanding? How many of us today plan to take some days off in the month of Ramadan? Do we have a plan? We do, waiting for the month of Ramadan. We are waiting for that. It's a moment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us time. Because this is the month of the maghfirah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So today, I need to leave from the place here. Not after 1 hour, right now, to make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Promise him not to do any mistakes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's kareem. He's kareem, he's generous. He will accept it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the middle of Sha'ban, the night of the 15, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to the sama' al-dunya al-ula, and he will forgive for all his ibad, all the sins. Do you like that? Do you like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive your sins? He would be there. Yaghfir, he will forgive everyone, illa ithnain, except two. Al-kafir, wal-iyadu billah, we don't count them. وَالْمُتَشَاحِنَانِ, the people who is not talking to each other, their brother by the tongue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, hold it until they clear the issue among each other. Today we have a phone in our hand. We don't lose it like before. It's under the pillow. You take it. Since you wake up in the morning, you look at the phone. It's in your job. You put in silent. We do, all of us. I'm not going to skip myself. So we have it. Text the person. Even he made a mistake and you know he's wrong. Just text him. Say, forgive me, brother. I forgive you too. Let's talk together. Let's meet together. But that's not only brothers. The real brothers from the same womb, from the same mom, not talking to each other because of the money issue. Sisters not talking to each other. People, they don't talk to their parents because my mom is not respecting my wife. Excuse me. She don't like my wife. Excuse me. Who did that? It's you. You didn't get them closer to each other. You don't understand the value of your mother, the one she breastfeeds you. She burned her life to let you be a man. Father bent his back, his bone is bending because he's working hard to feed you. And take, after you get married, after all these years, you become a man now, you ignore your parents, whatever you add in it today, because of both, because of your parents. I repeat it and I repeat it and I repeat it. So we can come to the issue that we need help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to help ourselves first. Clean your heart. You don't need to have an issue with no one of your family first, then your relative, then your neighbor, and in general. Come to the masjid and smile in the face of your brother and sisters. Come to the masjid if you see someone raise his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say to Allah, oh Allah, give him what he's asking you, Allah, if this is good for him. Because he can make dua on you and you accept it. You say ameen. So be careful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is great. So the month of Sha'ban, when we are in it now, we have to say it's a ghanima from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's something is good to gain it before our deeds go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need a good sahifa, a good book in our hand. We need to be among the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, take your book by your right hand. The day of judgment is hard. Think about it. From the time of Adam alayhi salam until the day of judgment, how many people were in the earth? Can you count it? You can't. But imagine the earth will be different earth, the sky different sky, and all this number of people will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَأْتُونَ فِرَادًا. And he will speak to every one of us individual. Individual. Imagine the day, how it looks. How is the heat come under the head of every single person? They sweat. Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu warda, he said the sweat can come to the neck here and to the nose from the scaring of this moment. Everybody gonna say, Ya Allah, finish. Even the disbelievers say, Ya Allah, put us in the hellfire, done. From the heat. When we come to the sadaqat and the zakat, you give it and name it as a sadaqah or zakah and leave it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please don't miss your sadaqat and you say, why I give it to them? They don't deserve it. I don't know the masjid, why they take the money, where is the money goes? Do you miss your sadaqat and your zakah? You missed it. The one who was the most generous, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, he put all his money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he became a khalifa, imagine that, a leader of the ummah, he finished everything he has, then he started to take some of the clothes to go to the market and sell it. When he meets Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu arda, he said, Ya Abu Bakr, where are you going? He said, I'm going to the market. How am I going to feed my kids? I have to do something. I have to do some business. Ya Abu Bakr, you are the leader of this ummah. You cannot do that. Let's go to Bayt al-Mal, the house of the Islam, the house of the zakah. You have a part of it. And the leader over there, Abi Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah. And when he went there, he said, Ya Abu Ubaidah, Abu Bakr, he went to the market to sell. We need to give him something. He said, sure, he has the right. We give him same as we give everyone else. Adl, justice, love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What about the day of judgment? Ya Abu Bakr, laka jilbab, you have one jilbab. one sheep to get the milk from. A little money seems like the other people. When your jilbab getting old, you return it and we give you a new one. Army. And if you left for something else and you not become a khalifa, return everything back. In the time of death, he take the promise from Aisha radiallahu anhu wa his daughter. Ya Aisha, I am now in the time of bad. You need a doctor, you need something, you need medication. He say, no, that's it. I already have it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's it, the time he's gonna die. And he said, Ya Aisha, return all the item I got it from Bayt al-Mal back again to Ubaydah bin Jarrah. That's how it is. When I said, as the ulama advise us not to mess your sadaqah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got two incidents. And for the same cause, the man who set up everything in the camel for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got an arrow and shot at him and killed him right away. The Sahaba said, Alhamdulillah, he's a shaheed, he's a murderer. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no. I saw him ruling in the hellfire wal iyadu billah. Why? He used part of the sadaqah to buy thawb for himself. The thawb is important. Imagine that. So when you gave the worry, leave it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second, when he was going by al-Baqiyah, and then he started to speed up, said, Ya Rasulullah, why you are speeding up? He said, if he has al-Qabr, thawbun min nar, from fire, turn around his man, because he used part of the sadaqah to buy jilbab for himself. So give and leave it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ لِيَلْهِ وَالْكِسَالِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulullah Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa ala. So my dear brother and sister, prepare yourself to end the month of Sha'ban the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like it. Please, when you give, do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Get closer to your family. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be here together in the month of Ramadan together to understand the Quran. Start opening the Mus'haf, start fasting. This is the most days that Rasulullah ﷺ used to fast. Fast, prepare yourself, eat a little, walk. It's too cold outside, do some exercise in your home, do some nawafil. Practice, let yourself ready for the month of Ramadan. Ad'u Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fahuwa ghafurun raheem. He will accept it from you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let qiyam al-layl, little bit, timing between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask everyone if they can help. Ask everyone to take care of the poor and need. Ask everyone if they can take the orphan. Ask anyone in the masajid, in the shura member, what do you need? How can I help you? Asking for blade, for cups. Yes, they eat together in the masjid. Wallahi, rahmah, ni'mah, gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you eat in the masajid every day in Ramadan. Meaning, you have the whole day, go to work and you have no more than the Quran and the Hadith and the Seerah. It save a headache, but the people who run all this show, is not easy for them. So make dua for them all the time, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala support them and lead them in the right path all the time. Use the money the right way. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaghfir lana dhunub wa yakaffir anna sayyiat wa an yashfi mardana wa yarham mawtana. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat al muslimina wal muslimat al ahya minhum wal amwat. Allahumma ashfi mardana wa mardal muslimin arham amwata wa amwat al muslimin. Allahumma sa'id ikhwanana fi Gaza. Allahumma ansurhum ala man adahum. Allahumma ansurhum ala man adahum. Allahumma alayka bi bani Israel. Allahumma arsil alayhim tayran ababil tarmihim bi hijaratin min sijil. اللهم انصر عبادك المستضعفين في الأرض اللهم تقبل شهداءهم وارحم نساءهم واطعم أطفالهم اللهم أنت أعلم بحالهم ولا يعلم بحالهم غير أنت يا كريم اللهم مدهم بطعام من عندك وشراب من عندك فأنت أرحم الراحمين يا رحمن يا رحيم اغفر لوالدينا ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا يا رحمن يا رحيم ابعد الشيطان عن بيوتنا وعن أبنائنا وأمهاتنا وأهلينا يا كريم اجمعنا مع الحبيب المصطفى في عليين اللهم ارزقنا شربة ماء من يد رسولك الكريم لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين
وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله، رحمني ورحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، وأقم الصلاة.